Good morning. In the last few classes, we were discussing aliphatic nucleophilic substitution reaction. Aliphatic nucleophilic substitution reaction. Now we are passing to next type of reaction, that is aliphatic electrophilic substitution reaction. Aliphatic electrophilic substitution reaction. Look at here. What is aliphatic electrophilic substitution reaction? For aliphatic electrophilic substitution reaction, four possible mechanisms are suggested. That is SE1, SE2 front, SE2 back and SEI mechanisms. Out of these four mechanisms, SE1 is unimolecular, and the other three, SE2 front, SE2 back and SEI, are bimolecular mechanisms. So for aliphatic electrophilic substitution reaction, previous class what was that? It was aliphatic nucleophilic substitution reaction. This is SN1 and SN2, that is nucleophilic substitution reaction. Here it is for aliphatic electrophilic substitution reaction, four possible mechanisms can be suggested: SE1, SE2 front, SE2 back and SEI. The SE1, the first one, SE1 is unimolecular, the other three are bimolecular. First we discuss bimolecular mechanisms. Which are bimolecular mechanisms? SE2 and SEI. In SE2 there are two mechanisms, SE2 front and SE2 back. So first we discuss bimolecular mechanisms, that means SE2 and SEI. It is like SN2 mechanism, bimolecular mechanism is like our SN2 mechanism, in which the new bond forms as the old one breaks. In the SN2 mechanism, the attacking nucleophile brings a pair of electrons and the leaving group takes away its electrons. This happened simultaneously. Here the nucleophile attacks the backside and resulting in the inversion of configuration. This point is very important to understand the difference between aliphatic nucleophilic substitution reaction and aliphatic electrophilic substitution reaction. So in nucleophilic substitution reaction, for SN2 reaction, we know that the nucleophile comes and attacks the substrate molecule from the backside. And one thing you have to remember, in aliphatic nucleophilic substitution reaction, that means in SN2 reaction, we know that here you can see that in SN2 reaction, the nucleophile comes with a pair of electron. The nucleophile comes with a pair of electron, and you can see that that nucleophile comes with a pair of electron, and that pair of electron is utilized for making a new bond with the substrate molecule. At the same time, this is our leaving group. The leaving group depart the substrate molecule with its pair of electron. So this is what is happening in SN2 mechanism. So keep it in mind, in the SN2 mechanism, the attacking nucleophile brings a pair of electrons and the leaving group takes away its electron. The leaving group takes away its electron because it is going as X minus, that means it's taking its pair of electron. Here the nucleophile attacks the backside. Why it is attacking the backside? Because the nucleophile is coming with a pair of electron and the leaving group depart with a pair of electrons. So in order to avoid the electronic repulsion, the nucleophile attacks the substrate molecule from the backside, and which will result in the inversion of configuration. That is what is happening in SN2 mechanism. SN2 mechanism, bimolecular nucleophilic substitution. But here we are discussing bimolecular electrophilic substitution reaction. So in SE2 reaction, what is happening? Look at it here. But in the SN2 mechanism, the attacking group is an electrophile. The SN2 mechanism, the attacking group is an electrophile. This electrophile brings a vacant orbital, that is important. The electrophile brings a vacant orbital to the substrate. Therefore, we cannot predict from which direction the attack must come. We can imagine two possibilities. They are attack from the front, that is SC2 front, and attack from the rear side, that is SC2 back. So unlike in SN2 mechanism, here a new electrophile comes. That electrophile means electron deficient species, or we can say that the electrophile is coming with a vacant orbital. The nucleophile comes with electrons, but the electrophile comes with the vacant orbital. So look at here, there are, if an electrophile comes with the vacant orbitals, there are two possibilities: attack from the front side or attack from the back side. So look at here how it is that here is our this is our substrate molecule and the electrophile. You can call it electrophile is E+. The electrophile comes from the front side. In the nucleophilic SN2 mechanism, the front side attack is not possible because the nucleophile comes with a pair of electron and the departing group is going with a pair of electrons. So there is electronic repulsion. Definitely the nucleophile will come only from the back side. But here it is not like that. The electrophile comes with a vacant orbital. Therefore, it can come in the front side, or it can attack the substrate molecule from the back side. First, suppose the electrophile comes from the front side. So this is our electrophile. It is coming from the front side. Then what will happen? This is our CX bond. This is our leaving group. X is our leaving group. When the electrophile comes from the attacks the substrate molecule, what will happen? This bond, the CX bond, breaks from the leaving group. So that means the bond breaks from X. It is breaking from X and the bond is joining with the electrophile. That means this is SC2 friend. This is SC2 friend. That, what do you mean by SC2 friend? Because the electrophile comes from the front side, then what we will get? We get, we get here what will come. Here it is E, and what will form? Plus X plus. Okay, this is what is SC2 friend. Now look at here, in the second possibility, the electrophile attacks the substrate molecule from the back side. So look at here, here it is our this is our okay, this is our substrate molecule, and here the electrophile comes and attack the back side. When it is coming from the back side, what will happen? You can see that the same mechanism, the CX bond breaks from the leaving group. The bond breaks from X, and you can see that this is breaking from X and it will join with E+. So what is that? Here it is SE2. It is attacking from the back side. It is attacking from the back side, and what we get here it is E and C. You can see that okay, here it is like that, plus EX plus. So these are the two possible attack of the electrophile in the SC2 mechanism. So the electrophile can attack the substrate molecule from the front side, or it can attack from the back side. Look at here, when the electrophile comes from the front side, we are getting retention of configuration. The configuration is retained. Here it is retention of configuration. Retention of configuration. When SC2 front side attack, what is happening? Retention of configuration. If the electrophile attacks from the back side, what is happening? There is a inversion of configuration. When it is attacking from the back side, there is a inversion of configuration. Here it is inversion. And so that is SC2 back side attack, and this is SC2 front side attack. So the SC2 front side attack associated with the retention of configuration, and the SC2 back associated with the inversion of configuration. So that's all about SC2 mechanism. Okay. And next is SCI mechanism. SCI mechanism, because SC2 and SCI both are bimolecular. Next is SCI mechanism. SCI mechanism. I means internal. That means electrophilic substitution reaction internal. What do you mean by internal? Okay, SCI mechanism. When an electrophile attacks from the front side, that means SC2 front, there is a possibility for a portion of the electrophile to assist the, in the removal of leaving group, forming a bond with it, and at the same time a new C bond is formed. So what is the what do you understand from this definition? Look at it here. This is our this, we are considering C2 friend mechanism, C2 friend mechanism. So this is our substrate molecule. So you can see that when an electrophile attacks from the front, there is a possibility of portion of the electrophile, that means a portion of the electrophile. Actually, electrophile means what you can say, in the previous case I have just shown with the E plus, or the complete electrophile means, suppose this is our complete electrophile, EZ, this is our electrophile, okay, this is our electrophile, then what is that, for a portion of the electrophile, this is the portion of the, this is E plus and it will change into Z minus, okay, this is our, or you can consider this is our electrophile EZ. And it can change into E plus and Z minus. Okay, anyway, this is the complete molecule EC. You can see that then what will happen? You can see that as we discussed earlier, this is our electrophile. When the electrophile comes, the bond breaks from the leaving group, and you can see that this bond breaks from X and it will join with E. And you can see that then this portion of the electrophile, the portion of the electrophile means this part. This bond breaks from E and it will join with X. Now look at here, a portion of the electrophile to assist in the removal of leaving group. This portion, that means Z with its pair of electron, will assist in the removal of X plus, the removal of leaving group. How? By making a bond with X. Okay, the, let's see, in the removal of leaving group, forming a bond with it, that means this portion, the portion of the electrophile, that means Z minus, will assist in the removal of our leaving group by making a bond with the departing group. At the same time, what will happen? The C bond will form. So what is that? This will result in the formation of, you can see that it will like this, and C is joining with E, and what will form? Plus the X is making a bond with Z. So you can see that this is SEI mechanism. Why it is SEI mechanism? I will come back. When an electrophile attacks from the front, this is our electrophile. The complete electrophile means EZ. This is our electrophile. A portion of the electrophile, that means from here, this is EZ, and a portion of the electrophile means Z, this part, this, Z with a lone pair of electron. How it will, to assist in the removal of leaving group, it will assist in the removal of this X. How it will assist in the removal of X? Forming a bond with it, forming a bond with X. This way it will assist in the removal of X. And at the same time, a new CE bond is formed. Now here you can see that this mechanism is also C2. Why it is bimolecular? Because the removal of the CE bond is forming, and at the same time CX bond is breaking. C2 mechanism means that is bimolecular, because the new CE bond formation and the CX bond cleavage, both are taking place simultaneously. That is why it is bimolecular. Here also it is bimolecular. And there is a retention of configuration. Now you can see that due to the internal involvement, due to the internal assistance, means a portion of the electrophile will assist in the removal of a leaving group. Because of that internal assistance, the backside attack of the electrophile is not possible. That is why it is known as SEI internal, electrophilic substitution internal. That means there is an internal assistance of the of a portion of the electrophile. Portion of the electrophile to remove the departing group, because of that internal assistance, the backside attack is not possible. Therefore, it is known as a SEI mechanism. SEI mechanism will also result in the retention of configuration, because of inversion is not possible, backside attack is not possible because of the involvement of the or internal assistance of a part of the leaving group with the leaving. Part of the electrophile, internal assistance of the of a part of the electrophile to remove the leaving group is taking place. Therefore, backside attack is impossible. This mechanism is known as SEI mechanism. So that's all about bimolecular electrophilic aliphatic electrophilic substitution reaction. So SE2, in SE2 there are two types, SE2 front and SE2 back, and other one is SEI. Okay, that's all about aliphatic electrophilic bimolecular substitution reaction. Thank you. We continue in the next class.